That looks so much better. I have gained the power of Shagorath. Is that all?
My lord, our Mazel Zuda sent me to find you. She requests your immediate assistance. Please accept my pardon, Lord, if I gave you such a false impression. The fault is entirely mine. The Armazel merely wants you to know that matters of the gravest import to the realm's security may be at stake. If it please my lord, she requested also that I inform you that time is of the essence in her humble opinion.
So, I am Shagorath. Kind of underwhelming, honestly. And we're back. Last time, we became Shagorath. So if you don't mind, I'm gonna sit on my throne. Which probably isn't the wisest thing to do, because a messenger also just came to us and told us that they need us rather urgently. So, let's go find out what they need. I have the Staff of Shagorath. I have my sword. And I have a sinking feeling we're about to fight Jyggalag.
Always a pleasure.
My lord, I'm glad to see you. We have a developing situation that requires your attention. Order. An obelisk has activated just outside the palace. I've ordered my Orioles to engage the enemy. I expect that this is the beginning of the final assault. The cursed usurper Jyggalag himself may even take the field before the end. What are your orders, my lord?
Can we do both? You know, you attack and then I'll lead?
It will be our great honor to fight by your side, my lord.
Defend the palace. You're no Daedric Prince. This ends as it always does. Order shall reign.
I captured a soul. Did I just soul trap a Daedric Prince?
Enough! I am beaten. The Grey March is ended.
Hallelujah!
For millennia, this drama is unfolded, and each time, I have conquered this land, only to be transformed back into that gibbering fool, Sheogorath. It was not always so. Once I ruled this realm, a world of perfect order. My dominion expanded across the seas of Oblivion with each passing era. The other princes, fearful of my power, cursed me with madness, doomed me to live as Sheogorath, a broken soul reigning in a broken land. Once each era, I was allowed my true form, conquering this world anew. And each time I did, the curse was renewed, damning me to exist as Sheogorath. Now, though, you have ended the cycle. You now hold the mantle of madness, and Jyggalag is free to roam the voids of Oblivion once more. I will take my leave, and you will remain here, mortal. Mortal, king, god, it seems uncertain. This realm is yours. Perhaps you will grow to your station. Fare thee well, Sheogorath, Prince of Madness.
Jyggalag has spoken to me and told me the Grey March is ended and the forces of order have retreated. Haskell will likely know how I should proceed. I can't help but think that I've unleashed a terrible evil on the world. I'm not sure whether it's Jyggalag or me. Well, you know what that means. Order's forces have retreated. That means it's time to loot the bodies. I'm over encumbered, of course I am. That weighs 300 pounds. That's probably part of it then. Haskell! My dear man! I'm afraid I need some help. I need some help. Okay, after that brief interruption, we're back again. So let's go see Haskell and see what he has to offer for us.
Always a pleasure. You've done it. Well done, Lord Sheogorath. I never doubted you for a moment.
Funny.
Now, of course, there is business to attend to. As you have assumed the mantle of Sheogorath, there are matters that deserve your attention. As Lord of this realm, there are a number of benefits to which you are entitled, as well as a number of duties to which you must attend.
I imagine I need to go pick some new dukes, because I can't continue on as the Duke of Mania, the Duchess of Dementia, and Sheogorath, right? So, tell me, what's my job now?
Your first duty is to attend to the needs of your subjects. you will find that there are constant threats to the residents of the Isles. Your job is to protect them, either by dealing with the matter yourself or sending your armies to take care of it for you.
Defending it from what, exactly? I thought we'd just beat Jyggalag.
It seems all is peaceful in the Shivering Isles, my lord. Will wonders never cease?
Okay, so what's the benefits of the job, then?
You may request any of the Golden Saint or Dark Seducer escorts at the castle to accompany you. They will defend you to the death. You may also summon entertainment to your throne room. Your predecessor found this most invigorating. Speak with me if you wish entertainment.
Do you get a jester suit?
You also have the ability to affect the weather in your realm. As it is an extension of yourself, it will often have an effect on you as well. You also have the benefit of Sheyogorath's protection. Cast this upon yourself, and if your life is threatened, you will be returned to your castle. Many of these abilities, Lord, are rooted in the magics of the Isles. Should you choose to leave this realm, they will not likely function.
Well, manipulating the weather sounds useful, because I don't like getting wet. I'll have to play around with that to figure out what it does. For now, let's see that jester suit, shall we?
You wish entertainment, my lord?
Let's send for dancing.
As you wish.
I stand ready, lord.
Okay, that actually makes me kind of sad. Because it's me now. It doesn't look the same. I need to start growing a beard.
I stand ready, lord.
And you're the court.
Yes,
healer,
what
yeah?
is it? Are you injured, lord? Do you require my services?
Well, I kind of got a pair of arrows sitting on my shoulder, but you know, other than that. What's all that then? That's a lot of spells all one time. Okay, that's good. Well, that's the world saved. So I guess it's time for
Always
us to go out.
Always a pleasure. Yes, is there something you require?
Do I have to stay here?
The Shivering Isles is what Sheyogorath wills it to be. It seems all is peaceful in the Shivering Isles, my lord. Will wonders never cease?
Well then, part of me says I should stay here and, you know, enjoy godhood. The part of me saying that, you know, godhood is all well and good, but this is just one world saved, if you know what I mean. That there's... I still have Cyrodil to save.
At your command, Lord Sheogora.
Ah!
And so with that in mind, I'm going to grab some weapons and armor from the blacksmiths here. which door was it again? Cut it open. It's over there. see if she can forge me a madness longsword. Bloody incentive. Blacksmith's not being open at all hours for the Lord of the Isles. Okay, first we need to get the ore out of our pack.
Why visit that other smith? Piercing flesh with my blades doesn't satisfy you? I've got the sharpest blades in the Isles. That seems fair to me. I can accept that. That seems fair to me. That seems fair to me. You got a good, fair bargain. You got a good deal there. I can accept that. If you need more.
Right, we're gonna put some stuff away in the bottomless bags because mods are awesome. More than a bit unsettled that I was basically able to soul trepidation prince, but whatever. Do I have any madness ore? No, I don't. What bag did I put that in? Got plenty of amber. Madness. There we go.
I do delicate. Tradition dictates before each master smith dies, she hides these magical molds in the world like pouring salt into a wound.
You'd like that, wouldn't you?
Over time, they soak in magical energies from the world around them, like you suck blood from a cut. Bring me a matrix and enough ore, and I will forge you a new item and bleed the magic of the matrix into it. What do you wish?
Build me an axe. Magic axe, yes.
Think of me fondly when you bury this axe deep into your foe's skull.
Charming.
Watch.
Give me a sword.
Carve a happy smile. Let the blood wash over your hands.
You are genuinely creepy, you know that? Okay.
What is...
magic boots.
Crush the skulls of the fallen under your boots. Stomp out their eyeballs with your heel. Paint the floor red in a bloody dance. What do you desire?
Give me a magic cuirass.
The enemy's blade will glance across the smooth metal. A gentle caress. What is your wish?
I do have a magic helmet.
The best way for a blade to slip into a man's brain is through the eye socket, ear hole, or through the nose.
I'm more disturbed than I should be that you know this.
What is your wish?
Give me some magic greaves.
Such strong blood pulses through the legs. What is your wish?
The only thing left is the gauntlets, which I don't have the thing for.
When the blood flows...
And some...
What do you do?
And a shield, too.
Properly timed blocking can stagger your foe. That is the time to caress him with your blade.
All right. We got some perfect armor going on. I'm, of course, over-encumbered because this thing is heavy as hell. So let's see what I look like with Magnus armor. Intimidating, but it's really not me. So we're going to be putting that in the heavy armor tag. And putting back our glass armor on. I won't waste your time with the amber armor, because while I might have the amber for it, I think it makes me look like a bumblebee, and I'm not gonna wear that stuff. Feel kind of guilty making this series, because as of this moment I have just over 80 hours on this save, of which
you
I recorded
me,
two. So I'm kind of dropping any new viewers into a strange situation, especially for people who haven't actually played Oblivion. My name is Carl. Carl the Alterer. It's been around, you know, maybe 72 days since I was dropped in the dungeon by the Emperor. Or whatever. Since that time, there's been a breakout. I got out with the Emperor. The Emperor was killed. And it's been a long story. Daedric Prince is trying to bring Oblivion close together. I'm going the wrong way. And, yeah. I can't even remember what I was going about when I left to find the Shivering Isle. I think it was something about going around to all the mages' guilds to get approval. You'd think that they would be more open to saying, "Hey, you're Shay-Gorath. Oh, wow, come join us." But I guess it doesn't work like that. I hear Baladius what's attacking me. Light going on. Okay, I don't see anything. I think this Baladius is forsaken. Anyway. The reason I'm going back to the other world is because Molag Bal, I think it is threatening to merge Oblivion and Cyrodiil. And if we don't stop him, that's going to be bad, because people will die. I feel like I should mention, at this point, there's probably still more I can do in the Shivering Isles. A few quests I haven't touched on, a few areas I haven't explored. I know there's at least one, because there's this town called Split, where everyone has a duplicate that they want me to kill. And I'm just not going to do that, because I don't have the time or the entertainment for that. It's from something over there as well, but for now, there's the world to save. And that's what we're going to do. Morning. You know, it feels like ages ago I came here. It is just Carl the Altmer. And now, I'm still Carl the Altmer. At the same time, I'm Jaguar. It's an interesting thought. I mean, how do you come to terms with becoming a god? I know, not a god, favorite prince, whatever, same thing out here. We're gonna head back to Cyrodiil. And see this? All of this, all this color, all this life. This is why I stuck around. Because I knew that if I didn't, the gray mark would come. And all would die. Why are they fighting each other? Mind. I don't mind. Here, have a friend. Here's the door to Cyrodiil. I wonder what the proper etiquette to a dangerous prince should be.
Hello there. You can't see me. You can't see me. Neither can he. No one can see me.
I am he, and I can see thee. Any comments?
Stay away from me. You've already spent too much time over there.
Oh, you like you would not believe. What's the name of that city over there again? Bravo. Alright. Alright, right. So, when last I left, we'd been sent to... Let me search the quest log. See, there was something about a ghost who appeared in the south of town. There had been some fighters who'd been causing trouble down in Leowen, I think. And I was being sent to go and retrieve some statues for a guy in the Imperial City. You know, it all strikes me as being strangely mundane after Shivering Isles. It's like, I'm almost literally a god. And I'm occupying myself with the day-to-day affairs of people who want me to collect statues. Is that really the best use of my time? Let's see. Let's check out that camp with the ghost. I was told he doesn't show up until 8 o'clock usually. So, airplane, but now it's 2:30. So let's spend our time exploring this ruin. I haven't seen you in a long time. Like, dozens of levels kind of long. That's all I'm going to be facing here. I could just walk through here pretty much. What did they say this room was called? Bon. Oh. That's useful. Also useful. Oh gosh, rats and ants. I'm back to level one, aren't I? Dead adventurer, huh? Oh no, you look like that orc I met earlier. Did you drop a sword? Oh yeah, that's my grieving process. Oh no, you look like that guy you just met. Where's your loot? Let's see, somewhere in here is a telekinesis spell. Just kill you. skeletons. Like, normally you get dread zombies and skeleton camps. I've never seen the two of them together. These guys would be a lot less scarier if I didn't have armor that basically denied all magical effects. I haven't played too much Fallout recently. I keep trying to take all with four. With R, I mean. Oh, it's a lich! Wonderful. Glad that this isn't one of the alien ruins that has all the traps in it, because I can deal with lots of enemies. I'm kind of built for combat. I have good armor, good weapons, good magic, but traps don't take any of that into account. Awesome. It's kind of a pity that Umbra does more than twice the damage, but whatever. Actually, that's an idea. Fix all this crap up. Yeah, still more than twice the damage. Oh well. But we've also run out of spells, so. Which way did I come in? Came in through there. Came along here. Okay, definitely go through here. Does this lead to a further area? Bon Loria. Sounds like library kind of stuff. So I need to figure out how to raise that then. Hey, there we go. What I wanted to see. So what was that supposed to do exactly? So this one will do gas. No? Yes, yes. Probably got some wraiths. They're the ones who are usually ones with the silent spell. Yeah. Wait, if this door, this doesn't lead anywhere except over there. No aliens, no welcome zones up there. No wonder I'm not seeing anybody. You know what? I'm gonna be stupid to just jump off because I know there's gonna be stairs somewhere. Where does this go then? Before we kill him, I should say, let's pull out some of our grand soul gems, because that's what these things are worth. I thought I saw a chest. Let's head upstairs. Where does this go then? Clever.
Ah!
Have I mentioned before that I don't like the lockpicking minigame? Hey, alright. Amulet of Luck. Useful, but not gonna wear it. Mercury Shield. That looks interesting. Is that a quest item? I've never seen anything like that. Or is it just a Dwarven shield with a unique enchant on it? Okay. That will be the way out, I assume. Yep, here's the door to the floor. We can head back up to Bonn. Wasn't there a second door? Yeah, there was. Let's figure out where that goes. Lots of welcome zones. Well, I won't give torch in the mouth. I will, however, need the right spell. Seeing that pop up. Okay. I was wondering why I kept seeing dialogue up as well, but it's not. And now it's nearly dark, so let's go check out a ghost. Here at the right place, I'm just here at the wrong time. I can't wait when enemies are nearby. What happens? something. You kept me up. Wait inside. There we go. Okay, so we got about half an hour to kill. Well, that's kind of like a well. No, just run. It's you. Are there any other mud crabs I need to kill? Give me a nice hit. There we go. Perhaps I should watch for a bit and see what he does. I'm not here. You can't see me. Well, I'm watching. Your spine looks like that can't be comfortable. Who are you watching for, sir? I guess we follow him, right? What are you thinking, sir? I'm sure this is such thrilling content for all of us watching right now. We're following the ghosts. Is that where we're going? That tower over there? Guess not. You gotta love how the life's gone, things that are obviously not alive, like ghosts and machines. Friend, have a nice walk. Oh, they're deer, okay. Don't need pillows. Well, I will if you keep getting away. No, seriously, where are you taking me? The river. And yes, the quest log says go ask Gilgondrin, but right here. Look, an Oblivion gate. That's not important. Right now, we're out of shit. I arrived at the mouth of the Panther. Beyond the tooth-like rocks is the remains of a small cargo ship named the MMA that looks like it sank a long time ago. I should investigate this wreck. I'm sure I never would have figured that out on my own. Is that a hatch? That door's locked. The MMA, a spirit attacked me. Those machines completely infested with them. I expect them to be the reins of the MMA's crew. Why this happened then puzzles me. I should press forward and investigate it further. Got a door to the lower decks. Got some beds. Captain's cabin. Because that would be easy to say, oh, this is why we're cursed. So, let's try the lower decks then. honest. More potions, but still no clues. To the MMA lower deck. I thought this was the lower deck. What did that guy say his name was? Grantham Blakely, so this is probably one of his crewmates. I found a skeleton chained to the wall in the lowest deck of the MMA. I believe these be the remains of Grantham Blakely. I should use the key I found to unlock his shackles. Or if I don't want to.
I knew one day someone with unyielding virtue would heed my words and speed my release. You risk much to perform such a selfless act. This noble deed will not go unrewarded. Look upon the ground in this prison. There you will find a map to my gratitude. I thank you with all my heart. Farewell.
So you couldn't leave because your dead body was right there? So it was shackled, so you were imprisoned there, but now that it's on the ground, you're okay?